Terry Jarvis of BBC Television made a film about the event and our history, and the Birmingham Evening Mail did us proud with a special supplement. While that was the centrepiece of the celebration and kicked off a whole month of those, there were many other programmes. Noel Edmonds came back to reminisce about Dingley Dell and Perkins Grange, as well as taking part in that Red Arrow's flypast. Emperor Roscoe too was back on the air for a one-off show. And we put on an archive jukebox where listeners could request broadcast highlights from the previous 25 years. On the actual birthday at King's Cross, British Rail named an intercity express train the Radio 1, and Simon Bates broadcast from it live as it travelled from London to Edinburgh. It arrived 45 minutes late for the actual naming ceremony due to a careless JCB driver who cut through a nearby signalling cable. We broadcast and the Daily Mirror published the all-time top 100 records, chosen by 100,000 of our listeners and the Daily Mirror readers. Simon Bates did his usual superb job in selling it, Bohemian Rhapsody was number one, and Sailing by Rod Stewart, number 100. The whole thing was rounded off at an industry party for all the DJs and staff at the Roof Garden, Kensington. Noel Edmonds came back to compare the evening. He was very annoyed, I remember, because the PA system was poor and he found it hard to make himself heard over the buzz of excited conversation. Exasperated, he told them he wouldn't continue until all the rude people stopped talking.